Okay, welcome guys. This is my fourth video with the session Angular tutorial. Mainly I will be covering with the Angular 12 version, that is the latest. So in this video I will be going through ngf directives. So normally everyone will tell you like what is ngf directive. ngf directive is nothing but which lets you hide and show element based on the condition you provide. Basically it requires boolean value. Okay, but what I will tell you like what are the various way you can use ngf, or in the practical sense, like in whenever you are working on the actual project, what are the various scenarios you can come across, and in that scenarios what are the ways you can use ngf. Okay, so you can see the bootstrap screen. This complete screen is developed with the bootstrap, so code I will be pushing to my GitHub, so you can take the code from there itself. Okay, so we have majorly three panels. In first panel I will show you like what are the various way we can use ngf directive. In the second panel, that is the practical example based on hide and show what we normally use ngf for. And in third, that is a practical scenario where we can use ngf to show icons based on the some conditions. Okay, so let's take a look. So ngf is a directive, it's kind of a structural directive. Okay, basically it requires boolean value. Okay, it doesn't matter it is coming from any variable, it is getting its value from any function, or simply you are comparing it there itself. Okay, so it requires true or false value. If the value is true, that element wherever you will place ngf directive, that element will be visible, otherwise it will be removed from the DOM. So those who don't know like what is DOM, it will be simply hidden, you cannot see it on the browser. Okay, if you can dip down into the what DOM is. Okay, but in this video I'm just concerned about ngf directive. Okay, so these are the three ways. Consider like each show is a variable which is having some boolean type value like true or false. So on the div I can apply star ng, I should be capital, is equal to in double quotes my variable name. Okay, this is the first way what normally everyone will or everyone might have known. Okay, this is the second way, like with ngf we can provide a function also. Since it is function, we have to use the round parenthesis. So what this function will do, it should return a value. And what value? Like true or false. Okay, so it should return a true or false value. Basically, so ngf required true and false value, so that it should get. Okay, third way is like we can compare in HTML itself. Like suppose we have this for loop, and on the for loop we have some values like gender is there. If gender is equal to male, I am showing this icon. If gender is female, I am showing this icon. You can see on Deepika and Saina, I have the lead female icon, and remaining we have the male icon. Same as it is status. If the value which is present in that object, it is true, I am showing this green icon. Otherwise, it is red icon with the cross, since we are showing the activation status off and on. Okay, so let's check the code. First I will show you the component code. This is the only variable which I have created, is show. Its data type is boolean. On the constructor I have provided the value false. Okay, so like in the previous video, in the first or second video, I have told you like what are the various way you can declare variable. So this is the normal initialization, plus in the constructor you have provided the value. Okay, so after that, student list is a one variable which is having data type any. I have declared it as empty, and on ngUnit I have just fill it with some basic object array. Okay, here in you can see name, city, stream, then is active and the gender property which we are going to use. Okay, so is active basically having value at true and false, and gender is having a string value which is having the value as male and the female. Okay, after that we have two functions, show. In show function we are just adding the true value to the issue variable, and in hide we are adding the false value. Then again we have one function, that get visible value. What this function is doing, it is returning the value which is whatever the issue variable is having. Okay, now let's check the HTML. So if you can see here in the middle section, we have, if I click on the show block, so you can see two blocks are visible. Okay, in first block using ngf directive, I mean directly we have applied star ngf. This is the div which I am talking. You can see this is the way how we write ngf star, because it is a structural directive. Structural directive normally normally start with the star. So ng, then I should be capital, if is equal to double quotes, whatever the value we have. On the top row, you can see all this code is bootstrap only. Nothing, custom CSS and everything, all everything classes is present in from the bootstrap only. So I have printed the value each show. So if you can see variable value, current value is true. So if this variable value is true and we have bind this variable using ngip on this div, so this div is visible. Okay. On this, we have two buttons like show block and hide block. On the respective two buttons, we have called our functions. On the first button, show, then on the hide button, we have called our hide function. Okay. So let me click on the show. Since it is already in the true state, so value is already getting true. Okay. If I click on the hide block, you can see the value is getting false. So now the div which we have applied ngip, it is removed from the DOM. Okay. So like removed from the DOM means what is actually means. So if you can see here, we don't have anything here. If I click here, you can see this div is there. Okay. This div where block using ngip directive is written. So if I'm clicking on the red button, which is for hide, you can see that element is removed from my page. It is no longer visible. Like the people who knows like what display none is. Let me add a, this is a div, and inside that div I'm just adding a property like display none. With adding display none property, you can see that div is hidden, but in the DOM means actual page, that div is present. We have just added a property with display none. Okay, so if I add the property display block, so you can see that div is visible. This is with the CSS, but in case of Angular, when we use ngif directive, what it actually does, it will actually remove the div, remove the particular element from your DOM. DOM is nothing but page object. Okay, so that is the difference what we do with display none and what we get with the ngif. Okay, so this is the first way. Now second way, like if you can see here on this button click, we have called our function. Okay, so in this function, what we are doing, it is nothing but we are adding, we are changing the value of each show variable with true and false. Okay, same thing we can do in HTML itself. Okay, so many of you might not be aware like how we can change value from HTML itself. So yes, we can change it simply like this. You can see the difference. In click, on click function, we have called one function. Same event handler, we have just this property is equal to true. So single equal to is, everyone knows like it is used for assignment. So we have just assigned true value on the click of it. Okay. So whatever the code we have written here, we can write the same code in the event itself. So what is the benefit? Like we are reducing one function. So if we know like on the that particular show event, we are going to replace that value with the true. So rather than creating function, we can do the same thing here also. So our function, that function will be removed. So our code will be cleaner and minimum code will be there in the, on the component.ts. Okay. So on the first button, you can see like each show is having value true, and on the hide, each show is getting assigned with the value false. So same output you can see here. Okay, same output. Third is like you might have required like some functionality where on the one button only you need to show and hide, like toggle functionality we might see. We call it as a toggle. Okay, so what I have done is like on the HTML itself, on click event, each show is equal to, I'm assigning the value of each show. I have just played the not. So not gets you the vice versa value. If each show value, current value is true, so it will return the false value. So this is the toggle what we can achieve simply with attaching the vice versa value of the boolean variable. So on the same structure, if I click this, you get to see the values which are displayed there. If I click on, then value gets changed. So same wise hide and show functionality is there. This is the normal way. These are the three ways. Like first is using event, then second way is changing the value on the event itself, and third is like toggle. And three ways, like if you can see the first block, we have used ngif with the direct variable, but in the last block you can see block using function which is returning value. So at the starting I have shown you this function get visible value. Okay, so this function is nothing but returning whatever the value we have in this variable. Okay, so I have used the same variable over here. Okay, so let me go to the top. So this is the top div where we have used directly variable ngip, then whatever the variable we have. But at the bottom we have used function. Since it is a function, we have to use the round parenthesis. Okay, so what this function is returning? True and false value. Okay, so like I previously told you, like ngif requires true and false value. So it doesn't matter like it is coming from variable, or if you are comparing, or if you are getting that value from function, anything. Okay, simply let, for the example, like I have put here 1 is equal to 1. Okay, since 1 is equal to 1 is equal to true, right? So this value is visible. If 1 is equal to 2, so this become false. So you can see, let me check what we have error. Let's check the error. Okay, reload. This is issue with the Angular 12. I think I have to restart it. Yeah. Okay. So these are the ways we use. Now in the third panel, you can see the table is there. In the previous video, I have told like how we use ngfor. This is the second directive, ngif. Ngfor was the first one, ngif is the second one. Okay. So again, like in this, all this video, I will be using previous concept. So you will know the actual use of the previous concept in the latest, whatever the topics I will be covering. Like in the previous video, we have seen ngfor. So in this video, we are going to use the same. Okay. So in the component.ts, you can see the student list having the array of object. Okay, these are having some fields like name, city, stream. The two prop fields which we are going to use is active and gender. Okay, if you can see in HTML, this is the static one. Okay, these are all again bootstrap classes, nothing custom CSS and everything. Okay, so ng for let student of our array name student list. So in the first ID, you can see like we have some icon, male icon is there, then female icon is there. Okay, so like how we did that, this is nothing but font awesome. Okay, simple fa and fa male icon is there to show the male icon. Okay, on that we have used the ngif condition, then student dot gender is equal to male. So this I tag will be visible only when student gender is equal to male. So then only this icon class will be visible. If student.gender is equal to female, then this I will be visible. Okay, same you can see here. For the girls like Deepika and Saina, you can see the female icon is there. Apart from that, we have the male icon. Okay, so in the last section. So this is compare. Like we are comparing string values. Okay, next I have told you like we can use directly true and false value. So student.isActive. So if you can see in the object, isActive is having values, I mean which is having data type true and false. Okay, so we can simply use that. We don't need to, I mean some developer do like this also. It is again same, but it is not necessary. Like you can achieve the same output, but with the ngif requires true. So basically if this variable is having the true value, we don't need to compare it with the true. Basically it is comparing with the true. So you don't need to compare it with actual is equal to and true and is equal to false. Okay, so this icon, user icon, will be visible if the student.isActive property is true. Okay, and if it is false, so for false I have just applied the exclamation mark, so it will compare with the vice versa. If the value is false, then this div will be visible, which is having 5 user times, which gives us the red icon. With this, because I have provided this red color, and the first one is having green color, success, and the danger class are on bootstrap, the same I have used. So you can see the same output here. Okay, so these are the different ways how we can use ngif. I will just recollect everything what we have seen. Okay, so these are the three ways, like we can pass directly variable to the ngif, then we can pass a function which is returning true and false value, either we can compare on HTML itself. With this basic, we have seen like what are the ways we can deal with the events. Like, this is the normal way. On the click, we have called one function show. The advanced way, like on the click, we are in HTML itself, we are changing the variable value. Okay, this is like a kind of interview question also. Like, someone might ask, like, is it possible to change value in HTML without writing function? So yes, you can use this assignment operator and change the value in HTML itself. All you need is a event to run that code. Okay, and third is a toggle. Like, we need on this one button only, we need the toggle functionality, like show and hide. So we can use that. Okay, so these are the ways how we can use HTML, and this is the practical example which actual when you will be starting on the project, this is the normal and the regular use you will be needing. Okay, so in the directive section, we have up to like ngfor is done, then ngif done. Then in the next coming session videos, I will be going through ng style and ng class. So till then, thank you. Stay tuned. Bye bye, guys.